guys, welcome to The Poke Resort, and today we are introducing a new series on our channel called Alolan Evolution Review. In this series, we'll be going over all of the Alolan evolutions and analyze them in six different categories, which are design, typing, ability, possible new moves, competitive analysis, and hype rating. If these categories sound familiar, then thank you for supporting my channel for so long, because this series will be the same format of my Mega Evolution series from 2 years ago. But out with the old and in with the new, so let's get into the new series by analyzing the Alolan Sandshrew line. The design of Alolan Sandshrew fits it almost as if this was its original form. It is literally an igloo. The bricks turning into ice blocks was so clever that it was meant to be. The head of Sandshrew looks like the entrance of an igloo or a winter coat with a hood on its head. Overall, perfect ice transition for Alolan Sandshrew. The design for Alolan Sandslash isn't as clever, but so much more badass. They exchanged the small spikes on its back to enormous icicle spears. The ice form transitions very well from the ground form, and Pokemon absolutely nailed this evolution line. The transition of going from a ground type to an ice steel typing is a big change competitively for Alolan Sandshrew and Sandslash. It is now 4 times weak to fire and fighting. However, it now is resistant to dragon, fairy, bug, psychic, flying, grass, and normal. Also being immune to poison, so it definitely has some promise. So far, the only known ability for Alolan Sandslash is Snowcloak. Snowcloak summons a hailstorm in battle as soon as a Pokemon with Snowcloak enters the battle. But instead of lasting for 5 turns, it lasts the whole battle until replaced. Well, since Alolan Sandshrew and Sandslash are completely different types than the original Sandshrew and Sandslash, they'll probably gain over 30 new moves that it will learn, so I'll go over 10 moves I think they are for sure to learn. And they are Icicle Crash, Ice Punch, Icicle Spear, Avalanche, Ice Fang, Metal Claw, Iron Tail, Iron Head, Bullet Punch, and Meteor Mash. I'm not the best battler, so I thought I'd bring in someone a little bit more experienced to give a competitive speculation. So here's Steve.
Internet, good morning. My name is Pokemon Trainer Steve, aka Magnitude, and I'm here to talk to you guys about Alolan Sandslash and its potential for competitive viability in the Sun and Moon metagame. I want to thank the Poke Resort for having me on this wonderful series that he's having, and I hope I don't let you guys down with the information I'm going to be giving you. We don't really know anything about Alolan Sandslash other than its typing, its ability. We don't know if it's getting any new moves. We don't know if it's getting any new stat distribution. So, we're going to speculate a few things. I believe the Poke Resort himself has a few speculatory moves that's going to be added to the Alolan Sandslash move pool. So, from there, we will create a viable set that Alolan Sandslash can use. Now, the first thing is, let's address the problems that Sandslash has originally. Sandslash, it's too slow, and its base attack is only 100, so it can't really be a useful physical attacker. Its HP is 75 and defense is 110, so it can't really be a useful physical defender. Sandslash is semi-decent as a hazard support mon by getting both Rapid Spin and Stealth Rock, so Donphan is the only other notable Pokemon that has those two moves. Other Pokemon do get them. But as far as what the role that those Pokemon have is, Donphan and Sandslash really share the closest relationship as far as physically attacking slow, Stealth Rocker, and Rapid Spinner go. The only role that it really excels in is a Swords Dance Sand Rush sweeper, but Alolan Sandslash loses Sand Rush, doesn't even get an ability that makes it faster in the hail, and it gets Snow Cloak, giving it plus evasion. People don't really use hail ever. They don't use hail. So why are we going to use an ability that all it does is make it evade better in hail? Alolan Sandslash, come on, you gotta get some good moves or some good stat changes if you want to be used ever. You got so many weaknesses. You're quad weak to fire and fighting, two of the already best offensive types in the game. So I believe Poke Resort has a list of moves that he is speculating that Alolan Sandslash will get. And those moves are as follows. Icicle Crash, Ice Punch, Bullet Punch, Meteor Mash, Iron Tail, Iron Head, Avalanche, Ice Fang, and Metal Claw. So what this does is it gives Alolan Sandslash an arsenal of new physically offensive moves. Now with all of its weaknesses and its lackluster stats, we gotta build something that can hit hard. So I bring to you the Choice Bandit Alolan Sandslash. Its speed stat is too low to really make a difference. Its HP is too low to really be bulky, so you want to bring this thing in, preferably under Trick Room. If you want to use Alolan Sandslash under Trick Room, fantastic. Now it gets access to Bullet Punch, Meteor Mash, Icicle Crash, Icicle Spear, all moves we want to give it. If it gets all these moves, fantastic. So I give you the Choice Banded Max HP, Max Attack, Brave Nature with a minus speed and zero speed IVs. The moveset as follows. Meteor Mash, Icicle Crash, Knock Off, Bullet Punch. Now those four moves are really the best thing you're going to get with Sandslash. So if you're running a Trick Room set, you can just spam Meteor Mash all day and you get Stab on that. That'd be juicy. Knock Off, of course, for some utility, because it's always nice to knock off opposing items, especially with a cornucopia of items appearing in every generation. You want to be able to get rid of those items when you can. Bullet Punch for a priority and Icicle Crash for, well, a stab ice move with a potential flinch. There's a reason why Weavile wants Icicle Crash over Ice Punch. It's obviously for raw power and the possibility to flinch, though missing that move in a crucial situation, well, that's never good. There's nothing really else Alolan Sandslash wants to do. It doesn't want to take a hit because of those fire and fighting weaknesses, and it can't outspeed anything, so it's too slow to, with a low HP stat, it can't be a good tank. You gotta run Trick Room Sweeper. It's lost its ability to use in the sand. It doesn't have any good defenses, assuming, of course, again, I cannot stress this point enough, assuming its base stats do not change. We have no inkling or even reason to believe that they're going to be changing the base stats of these Pokemon, because all we've gotten are new Alolan forms, different types. We have nothing on the stats. So we're going to assume those stats are staying the same. But obviously with new types comes new attack. They wouldn't make Sandslash Steel Ice and not give it Stab to work with. That'd just be poor that all these Alolan Pokemon aren't going to be getting Stab to work with. So assuming the stats are correct, Choice Banded under Trick Room Alolan Sandslash is the way to go here.
Overall, I believe Alolan Sandshrew and Sandslash are great additions to Pokemon Sun and Moon, and they look amazing. Their new types will be great to see in the competitive game, and I really believe all the Alolan forms will be very competitive to give new light to the original Pokemon. That is why I'm giving Alolan Sandshrew and Sandslash an 8.5 for my hype rating. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like. If you haven't subscribed yet, do it now for more content like this. I want this to be an interactive series, so leave your comments in the topics I cover today so you can list your opinions for the new Pokemon. Here are other videos if you're interested in other resort content. Have a good one, guys, and I'm out.